Hello and good morning, good evening, good night, good day, I don't know. My name is Lee, obviously as you read probably on the title card. This is a speed paint of my D&D character, Orin. Orin's full name is Orin Gatha Kanathi. If you know that name, you're right, he's a Goliath, a mountain-dwelling Goliath specifically. Orin was kind of an outcast among Goliath culture. He is short for a Goliath, he's a little skinny for a Goliath, and he did have a tendency to get a little sick, just like the sniffles and stuff like that. You know, no biggie, but for Goliaths, when, you know, the world is very harsh, it's very cold, it's very unforgiving, their conditions that they live in are, you know, pretty extreme. It was a little concerning to the Gatha Kanathi clan. Orin kind of set out to prove himself that he, don't judge me as I completely just struggle back on these stupid braids. I know that braids are supposed to look like hearts, so I was trying my best here, but it just doesn't, I still really need to practice on the basics. I'm not here because I'm good, I'm here just because, you know, I'm dedicated. But Orin tried to go out and prove himself. He tried to kill and bring the pelt of a saber tooth. He lost, and he was rescued by a druid, an archdruid specifically, who shared his craft with Orin, and Orin learned how to become a Circle of the Shepherd druid. In his original iteration, he has become an NPC in a game I've been running for about 4 years now. But he is... At the time, he was pretty reluctant leader of the gang, so to speak. He was in, before he met the gang, the traveling companions, the champions, the heroes, whatever you want to call them. He was with his partner for quite some time. He would pretty much come to learn a lot of ways to heal people and help them, and he really became well respected in the Goliath community, which is always great. A little sad that, you know, you couldn't just, I guess, be yourself, but here I am instilling bad morals. Moving on. Eventually, his lover disappears, leaving nothing but a note that says, "Find me." And eventually Orin does leave the clan, meets up with the gang, and that's how he begins that story. That campaign, unfortunately, was quite short-lived. The GM at the time was going through some pretty major life changes, and so at that point I was like, I don't run a campaign. I never run a campaign. I would argue that I was barely even a player. I mean, I had played, but few and far between. I originally started playing tabletop with the Star Wars tabletop. I think it was the Star Wars Pathfinder specifically. I have played Fading Suns, lots of Pathfinder. And then I got into D&D about the same time I moved halfway across the dang country to, you know, pursue my big girl job. And so I took over, and at that point I NPC-ified Orin because, you know, GM. Orin doesn't have too much of a role in the current campaign that he is in. He's more of an auxiliary, aware character. One of the druids, or there is a druid in the party. You know, they could be buds if they wanna. You know, it's whatever. But they have a little bit more pressing matters on their hands. I have not really seen Critical Role. It's not that I haven't wanted to, it's just podcasts or just things that involve a lot of, you know, paying attention isn't really conducive for the type of work I do. I have to really be focused to what I am doing in my job. And so I hadn't ever heard any of the Critical Role campaign, but my campaign does involve Asmodeus, it does involve the Hand, and I am Vecna, and the group is where, the one where he's an NPC. They're currently taking an army to Luskin that has been laid siege by demons, and is actually currently, I would say it's a homebrew light. I kind of repurpose some characters, but I don't necessarily, like, create my entire world. I will tell you that this channel is going to be a kind of, I don't know, visual documentation of my descent into madness. I mean, of my GMing as in a complete homebrew setting. I am eventually, this campaign, the Waterdeep one that we're in, has been running for about 4 years, 4+ years, and it's coming to an end soon-ish. Probably within the next month or so, actually. As I said, they're marching armies up to Luskin with the hope of eradicating the demons and Camariel, who is gone and done a baddie, much to Jarlaxle's dismay. And so we're gonna see how that all works. See if I TPK or not. I probably won't. Admittedly, I've just been kind of learning how to be a GM. I've never GM'd before in my life, as I think I said. I don't know. I've recorded this like 3 times now. The next world that I'm creating is called Telemotu, and it is kind of somewhat inspired by mini, you know, like, I would say kind of like the Florida Keys area. But it's not necessarily the Florida Keys. It's just when I was drawing a map, I needed some kind of visual reference. And so I was like, oh, there's a bunch of small islands. Basically, it's a different rendition of the D&D version of the Golden Age of Piracy, because my players were like, hell yeah, pirates. And so now we are going down into pirates. Very excited for it. I have a lot of NPCs, I have a lot of art that I've already started, and I've been pre-recording. And so I'm going to start eventually using this channel as a visual representation of Telemotu, and, you know, probably other characters that I like drawing. I had a lot of fun with Orin. I thought that when I was doing pose select, so to speak, I really wanted to be able to show off the saber-tooth head. You know, I could have made it less flat, but, you know, I'm not here to be perfect. I'm here just for funsies. And, in general, learning how to draw a saber-tooth tiger head was not easy. I am not a trained artist. I am a person who actually started drawing consistently. I didn't start drawing consistently until I was in law school. And so... I was not a person who started art when I was like 8 or anything like that. I'm a late bloomer. I've had a lot of catching up to do. My art is by no means perfect. It's by no means professional, but it's mine, and I'm pretty impressed with it. As for my older videos, I fell down the rabbit hole of Steve and Bucky, and that's where a lot of my attention went, I guess I could say, but I grew from it. I got really okay with my art. I wouldn't say it's the best thing ever, as I've said like multiple times now, geez, but I'm pretty impressed with myself. It's not a stick figure, and that's honestly pretty impressive to me, especially as somebody who didn't start drawing until they were like a legitimate adult. When I first started drawing, I actually originally started drawing like Tim Burton characters, and I'm going to eventually start show some old art on my TikTok. And when I start posting there, I'm trying to kind of like build up a couple recordings first on all platforms before unleashing the beast, so to speak. But yeah, that's a little bit about me. Now back to Orin. Orin is, as you can see, I'm currently working on the background, getting the mountains. They're very cartoony. I like the cartoony styles. I do sometimes fall a little into anime-esque, semi-realism-esque on the piece, and honestly, I don't even know what's a style. What is a style? Because I have like 10. But yeah, that is Orin, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye!